Hi everyone, and welcome back to the Shikal Now series, the series that will make good Shikal users great Shikal users. In this session, I will talk about how to use Shikal for your U-value calculations. Even if the program does the calculations in the background, it's the input you give the program that affects the result. I will show you various parameters and how to change them and what impact they have on the total U value. And you will see that it's not always the most obvious change that has the biggest effect of the result of the U value calculation. So let's open Shikal and have a look. Here is an example of a ribbon window. Often you are given a target U value in the project that you have to fulfill. And let's say in this case it's 1.0 watt per square meter Kelvin. As you can see, the U value is not currently good enough with 1.1. As I will show, there are many ways of reaching the desired U value. And now you have to think about what is the most beneficial way for you as an entrepreneur. Let's start with changing to a glass with a lower U value. As you can see down here, I have currently have a glass with U value 0.6, and I will now change it to a glass with U value 0.5. So I go to load to get to my project glass, and I pick my glass with 0.5 in U value. Press OK, and there I have reached below the target U value. Now I will show another way of improving your U value, and this is to change the profile system. In my first calculation, I was using AWS 75.SE, and now I'm going to upgrade to Shuko AWS 90SI Plus. To start with, I had used AWS 75SI, and now I change to the battery insulated AWS 90SI Plus. And as you can see here, this way I also reached my target U value. In my opinion, this is a better way to reach the desired U value because you improve the weakest link. And the weakest link in this case is the profile system. It has a higher U value than the glass. And especially up here in the Nordic countries, when it's really cold outside, if you have too much difference in the U value between the glass and the profile system, you will feel colder areas at the profiles. And by improving the profile system, you will have a more even temperature inside your construction. Now let's have a look at the third way of changing the parameters in Shikal to reach your desired U value. This is actually my favorite way, is a lot of times the Shikal user already have a good enough solution on his program, but he has forgotten to tell the Shikal program what spaces he's using. And when you hear spaces, some of you know that I'm talking about the psi value. When you do calculations according to the European norms, you enter different U values for different areas of your construction. In this case, the glass has one U value, the profile system has another, and in the intersection between the glass and the profiles, you will enter a psi value. And that this is much dependent on the spacers. So if you haven't told Shikal that you're using good spacer, it could do the calculations with a really bad aluminium spacer. So make sure you go into your glass configuration in Shikal and choose the spacer you're actually using, or the one you need to tell your glass supplier that you want to use to reach your desired U value. As you can see on the screen, here is a table we got from Rosenheim, a research institute where they have collected various spacers from different suppliers, and they have summarized the psi value calculations in different windows material like aluminium, wood, PVC, etc. And here you can see that there's a big span of psi values depending on what spacer you use. The worst ones are the old aluminium spacers, and the ones with best performance nowadays is made of composite plastics.
These ones has huge effect on the total U value, and my experience is that a lot of Chicale users has not specified these correctly when creating their glass in Chicale. Here you can see aluminium, PVC, wood, and wood and aluminium combined. And you have double glazing and triple glazing. So aluminium has a high value, which means that a lot of energy travels through this part. And the development has grown rapidly. And now when we scroll down, we can see that the psi value nowadays is reaching towards 0.03. And Schüco has already programmed all the psi value for the various spaces that we have got our hands on, but sometimes you use a spacer that are not in our lists and you can't find it in Chicale, then you can enter it manually. But make sure you have a value from your glass supplier.
And as I will show in Chicale, this will have huge impact on the total U value.
So let's have a look at the spaces in the glass. First, I will change back to the original profile system, back to AWS 75SI. So now we're back to 1.1 in U value. So when I open up my glass construction, I scroll down to spacer. And here when it says manufacturer independent, it normally tells you that you haven't entered any spacer, told the project what spacer you want to use. So for this example, I will use an EdgeTech Super Spacer. And here I can tick this box, and then Chicale will use the data we got from the research institute. If I'm using a spacer that's not in Chicale, I can choose producer independent and untick this automatic psi value box. And then I can enter the psi value that I get from the spacer supplier here. But for Super Spacer, we already got the value. So I tick this box and I hit OK. And if we look at the total U value calculation, I'm now down to 0.85. So in this case, this had much more effect on the total U value than changing the glass or changing the profile system.
To summarize this session, I have shown you three ways of improving the U value of your Chicale position. I have changed the glass, I have changed the profile system, and I've also changed the spacer used in the insulated glass. And there's no golden rule which the best option when you do a project. You have to, by your experience, judge what's improvements that it's most beneficial for your project. And sometimes you have to combine several of these changes to reach your desired U value. But if you want to discuss this further, don't hesitate to call your local Schüco technical support. And we're happy to discuss U values and how to optimize these in the future. Thank you so much for listening. It's been a pleasure to teach you more about Chicale, and I hope to see you again for our next Chicale Now session.